हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इनकम टैक्स क्लास. आई एम अर्चना भट्ट. सो इट इज डिक्लेयर्ड दैट ऑब्जेक्टिव टाइप क्वेश्चंस विल बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम. सो गारंटेड क्वेश्चंस विच कैन बी आस्क्ड ऑन कैपिटल गेन. लेट अस डिस्कस सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस. दीज आर द पैटर्न एंड These questions can be asked. You can say it is 80 to 90% chances are there. Other than that, they can ask some calculations. I will tell you how they will ask calculation if they ask the objective questions on calculation of capital gain or something like that, and how you have to study MCQs. When there is a MCQs on practical subject, okay. So have studied CS executive, that was MCQs only, income tax MCQs only. So I know how you have to study and how they will ask questions on practical subject, because cost tax were MCQs only. Okay, now also MCQs, maybe new syllabus they have changed. I don't know recently what they have done, but cost and tax they used to ask MCQs only. Okay, so here there are some questions, important questions which can be asked in the exam. 90% guarantee I can give you. 10% I don't know what they do it, because I have not received the sample questions or something like that, sample paper or something like that. So this I have prepared some questions, and I will explain you how you have to study. Without wasting time, let us see in income tax, in that objective questions and answers, MCQs on capital gain. Now the first question is, the capital gain is the gain which arising from the transfer of land and building only. Here you have to concentrate each and every word when there is a objective questions. Okay, so now here land and building only. Then capital asset, share of blue chip company, all of the above. So you feel that everything includes all of the above, right? But here it is, the answer is capital asset. All right. Now I have written the note also. This is how you have to study. So here, as per section 45(1), so this is important, you remember this. Here they have given what is capital gain. They may ask capital gain charging section or capital gain section, defined under which section they may ask. They may give 54(1), 45(1), then 43(2), something like that. They give you confusing sections. When it comes to sections, you get confused. So that is the reason. So here, when you are reading the definitions or any important note, you have to concentrate, and this is how you have to study for MCQs. Here, this is one questions, the pattern I have given. But they may ask question on in different types in definition only, right? So now here they may ask this section, any profit arising from the transfer of capital asset is called capital gain. Now such profit or gain will be transferred. Such profit or gain on transferred asset is taxable under the head capital gain. They may ask question with this. So here you have to study like this. Here, as per section 45(1), any profit arising from the transfer of capital asset. Your answer is capital asset. You feel that these are the things related to capital asset or capital gain. But answer is this, B. Answer is B. Okay. Next. In this, they may ask section capital asset and capital gain. Three important things. Okay. Next, second question, which of the following is not regarded as transfer of capital asset? Which of the following is not regarded as transfer of capital asset? They have mentioned, I think I have sent you the notes also, which are not a capital asset. So you have to remember all the things. So here, which of the following is not regarded as a transfer of capital asset? Either you study not regarded transfer of capital asset, or else you study what all things comes under the capital asset. So here both you have to study. Things comes under what are called capital asset, and you have to study what are not transfer of capital asset. Okay? So both you have to study. Here, conversion of asset into stock in trade. No, this is set. Next, sale or exchange of an asset. It is also an asset, capital asset. Transfer of capital asset. Redemption of zero coupon bond. This is also comes under the transfer of capital asset. So here, any transfer of capital asset under gift or will or any irrevocable trust. So this is not regarded as transfer of capital asset. This is not regarded as capital asset. So answer is C. Okay. Next. Note. Here I have given the note because this is important. This is how you have to study. Where it has given. Okay, that is the reason I have taken these things. Now, note, in this transaction not regarded as a transfer, in this first one, any distribution of capital asset on the total or partial portion of HUF. Any distribution of capital asset on the total or partial portion of HUF also not regarded as transfer of capital asset. Here, any one of this, they may mention it, or else they may give you which is transfer of capital asset. In that, they may give you 1, 2, 3, then one redemption of zero coupon bond, and then they may give you all of the above or none of the above. Are you getting my point? Iga transaction not regarded as transfer ide alla idralli eradanna kottidara avaru idu book alli ide. Okay, iga heegu kodabodu athwa reverse allu kodabodu idanna innond yavadadru option kottu idralli yavadadru option kottu sale or exchange of asset kottu amel none of the above kodabodu aga which is regarded as a transfer of capital asset anta kelidre you have to mention sale or exchange of an asset. So you should know these things. So this is how you have to study. I hope now at least you are getting the idea how they ask multiple questions. Okay, multiple choice question. So this is important, remember this. Next, third question, which of the following expenses are disallowed while calculating capital gain? So here, which of the following expenses are disallowed while calculating a capital gain? Expenses on transfer of asset, cost of improvement of asset, security transaction tax, cost of acquisition of asset. Disallowed expenses. Expenses on transfer of asset, we take it while calculating net consideration, we take it. Cost of improvement also we take it. Cost of acquisition also we take it. Only thing is we don't take this. Here disallowed expenses is security transaction tax. Here disallowed, which is not allowed while calculating capital gain. So here expenses we take it, securities of transaction tax we don't take it, cost of improvement we take it, we have done the calculation also, cost of acquisition of asset also we take it. So here answer is C. Here note. Here I have given the note also where it has provided and how you have to study. So here note, expenses on transfer means any expenses incurred wholly and exclusively in connection with the transfer of any asset. Exclusively wholly and exclusively in connection with the transfer of. They may ask question on this also. Okay, multiple questions on this also. So now example, brokerage, commission on sale, expenses on transfer, cost of improvement, these are the things also they take it as expenses on transfer and calculation of capital gain. Okay, next, take it for capital gain also. So they may ask question on this also. So that is the reason here I have taken this. Okay, I hope you are clear. Let us go to next question. Short term capital gains arises from the transfer of an asset which is held by the assessee for not more than 24 months or less. Not more than 24 months or less in case of share not listed. Correct. That is considered as short term capital gain. Next, 12 months in case of zero coupon bond and any other listed securities. Here listed securities, UTI, mutual unit of mutual fund and zero coupon bond. These are the four is 12 months or less. Here not unlisted shares with the recognized stock exchange, 24 months. Remember this important, they may ask question on this also. So here what all things comes in 12 months? Listed securities, then UTI unit trust India, then mutual fund, unit of mutual fund. Four things you have to remember: mutual fund, unit of mutual fund, then zero coupon bond. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, remember this. Okay, next, 36 months in case of capital asset mentioned in A and B, that is the list A and B. I have given you A and B, what all things under capital asset, 12 months, then 24 months, listed, unlisted, everything I have given list. So here answer is all of the above. Answer is all of the above. So here it is B. Okay. Answer is D. Now next question. This is how you have to study. While studying these things, you have to study with connection of that things also, means in detail. Then you will get, if they ask any question, you are able to answer it. Okay. Iga yen question iga MCQs nan idana pattern kotidene. ಈ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನೋಟನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಈಗ ನೀವು ಇದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದೆ ಕೂಡ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗನ್ನು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನಿಂಗ್ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ I hope you can understand how you have to study. Okay. Now, here next is if unlisted securities are sold after 12 months, capital gain arising from such sale. If unlisted securities are sold after 12 months, capital gain arising from such sale is short-term capital gain only. Because unlisted securities 24 months or less, remember. So they may ask question like this also, or less, right? So here short-term capital gain only. So because of this reason, I'm telling you, you have to read very carefully. Otherwise, even though you know it, you may write wrong answer, but here you don't get, 4 out of 5, you get 3 or something like that. But here, 1 marks or 2 marks, you are missing means you are wrong means wrong only, right? So, next. So, here, this is about unlisted securities. So here 24 months or less, remember, because this is related to here only. So that is the reason I have not given any note. Next. Sixth question. Conversion of cost price of asset into present price is known as cost of acquisition, long term capital gain under section 45(1). I have mentioned this section because I want you to remember this section also. Next, cost inflation index under section 55(2). Remember this. Okay. So here answer is conversion of cost price of asset into present price is known as cost inflation index. Using cost inflation index, we get the present price of the asset. So here answer is D. You have to go through the cost inflation index, you have to go through cost of acquisition, you have to go through capital gain. If you remember the definition of all these things, if they ask question on any of this, you are able to answer. Okay. So here the answer is D. Okay. Next. Exemption under section 54 is available to. Here exemption under section 54 is available to sale of residential house. So here the answer is, you may get confused, individual, HUF, both individual and HUF, all SSE. So here answer is both individual and HUF. See, each and every section from 54 to 54H, you have to remember these things. It is for all, some things are for individual, some things are for individual and HUF, some things are for all SSE. So you have to remember these sections and the details of this. I have given, I think, 9 conditions, right? Transfer of asset, exemption related to transfer of assets, so that you have to go through it. So capital gain sale of residential house, this is related to capital gain on sale of residential house. Okay, remember this, you have to go through this. Okay, so next, exemption under section 54B is available for. Here 54B or 54D, let me check once. So here 8th question, exemption under section 54D it is available for transfer of any capital asset, compulsory acquisition, sale of residential house, all of the above. Here answer is compulsory acquisition. You have to remember this. I have given you this. If I have not, if I haven't sent notes, I will send you the notes. Don't worry. Okay. related to compulsory acquisition of for we have discussed while discussing when I have discussed compulsory acquisition of land and other things for social welfare like rail, transportation and other things. I explained this thing. I don't know whether you remember it or not. And here notice, please remember the exemption section 54 to 54H. Different condition, exemption conditions and situations. Okay. So next. Here answer is B. Compulsory acquisition. Answer is B. Okay. Next. Tax on long-term capital gain is 20%. This also I have discussed. Okay. So here tax on long-term capital gain and short-term capital gain, both you have to remember. They may ask short-term capital gain also. Your normal rate, I think I have discussed these things. It is there in video also. While discussing short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain, I think I have discussed. I think I have discussed a difference also. While discussing the difference, I have discussed. If I haven't, I will send you the notes with this. Okay, you get in books also. Please go through the other things also. Not only this, along with long-term capital gain, at the same time you have to learn short-term capital gain also. Okay, so this is the pattern. I cannot give you exactly what they ask in the exam. Okay, so these are the questions they may ask. It possibilities are there. Okay, next question. This I will send you, don't worry. For claiming exemption under section 54B, 54B, here it is, 54B means 54B, the new agriculture land we should be purchased within 5 years from the date of transfer, 2 years from the end of the relevant previous year, 2 years from the date of transfer, 3 years from the date of transfer. Here it is 2 years from the date of answer, so sorry, transfer. So answer is C. This I have discussed. I know, I remember. Now, next. Exemption under section 54EE is applicable to individual and HUF, all SSC, none of the above. So here answer is all SSC. Okay. Here similarly, when it comes to 54 to 54H, you have to study the applicable to whom and what are the conditions. Here applicability, you have to learn applicable and you have to learn the conditions. Remember, you have to remember this. That is why I told you when there is MCQ, if we have knowledge, then only we can write the answer. It is not like descriptive. Okay. So here it is all SSC. Please study this and this related to section 54 to 54H. If you don't have study material, please send me. I will please tell me or please send me the message. I will send you the material. Okay. Next. Which statement, which one of the statement is true? Here. Agriculture land in rural area is a capital asset. No. Wrong. Capital asset includes both tangible and intangible assets as per section 214. Yes, correct. Gold bonds under the gold deposit scheme Capital gain arises transfer of any asset? No. So the answer is capital asset includes both tangible and intangible asset as per section 214. Remember this. That is the reason I have written this section also. Okay, you have to remember this section. Next. Here, what all related to capital asset, what are not related to capital asset, what are not included under capital asset, you have to remember. Here, stock in trade, agriculture land in rural area, then gold, some schemes, right? So, you have to remember these things. So, this also I have discussed, I remember. Okay, next. A residential house is sold for rupees 90 lakhs. Your calculation, how they ask calculation question. So here it is, sale of residential house. Let me take here. Sale of residential house 90 lakhs. Okay, then capital gain after these things, after deduction and other things, you get 50 lakhs capital gain. In this capital 50 lakh, residential house has purchased, SSC has bought two residential house. For one, he has bought, in the sense he has purchased two houses, that is house 1 plus house 2, 30 lakhs plus 20 lakhs respectively. Amount eligible for exemption under section 54 would be 50 lakhs. However, it is 50 lakh only, right? So here answer is 50 lakhs. So here you have to remember the deduction, amount invested or actual capital gain, whichever is less. Amount invested or actual capital gain, whichever is less. So here 50 lakh, 50 lakh only. So here 50 lakh. Answer is 50 lakh. Okay, I hope you are clear. Next. Cost of improvement shall be considered for calculation of capital gain, always taken as nil. Always considered irrespective of period when it was incurred. No. Considered when incurred on or after 1/4/2001. Cost of improvement before 1/4/2001 is not allowed. Deduction is not allowed. Right? We don't do that. So here we don't take for, we don't consider for calculation if it is one before 1/4/2001. This I have done one question also, right? Last video I have discussed this. So considered when incurred on or after 1/4/2001. So answer is C. Next. The assessee allowed to the market value as on 1/4/2001 in case of all capital asset which are depreciable asset, all capital asset other than tangible, intangible asset, only self-generated asset. Here you have to concentrate the wordings, only self-generated. There self-generated assets and other also it is there. You have to go through this. Market value and note, read cost of acquisition being the fair market value as on April 1, 2001. You have to go through this. Yeah, there are other list also. You have to go through the list. Okay, so here all capital asset. No, it is not for all capital asset. All capital asset which is depreciable asset. Yes, correct. So here answer is B. So here only self-generated assets. So here if you go through the list, here there they have given self-generated assets and others. So all capital asset other than intangible asset, wrong. So here it is, answer is B, all capital asset which are depreciable asset. Okay, not read the cost of acquisition, this you have to study. Here it is there in cost of acquisition, in that fair market value. Okay, so here fair market value, and because whichever is cost of acquisition or purchase, whichever is higher, right? So this also you have to remember. If it is before 1/4/2001, remember these things, these are important. Okay, so some of the questions which can be asked in the exam as a multiple choice question. So there are other questions also related to calculation. I will try to cover those things in next video. So thank you for watching. This is how you have to study. When you are studying these things, and you have to study about all these things, each and everything you have to study. In intangible asset, what are thing comes? Tangible assets, which thing comes? Because capital asset includes tangible and intangible asset as per section 214, right? So these are the things you have to remember. This is how you have to study for MCQs. Okay, thank you.